That's what it is when you live trying to keep it low key.
All right, so we out here at the Mattyb book signing. We're lit right now, as you can see. About to roast him. All right, no, now it's working. All right, so basically what's going to go down is I'm going to go up to him. And I'm gonna spit in his face, and I'm gonna talk about his girlfriend. And say we love you, Mattyb. Ready? 1, 2, 3. Yeah! But she's my girlfriend.
Oh, no, I'm not.
Yo, chill. You think you're gonna be in this?
I'll be in it.
Don't touch my camera, bro.
Let's get it. You know me, always finding myself in interesting times. Growing up, sharing my story through these intricate rhymes. So check it, I'm at this dime. She looked kind of familiar, but people change with time. And I couldn't remember her, so I shook up a conversation. Nothing unusual, Maddie, but after a couple hours, I knew it was unusual. And I'm ready to tell everyone that I know. But she like, yo.
I'm sorry that I'm your daddy. I'm laughing up in your face, you maggot. I'm packing your makeup in this bag, and you look like Justin Bieber, except he was kind of decent. Oh my God, please don't hurt me. Like, boy, give me a reason. Got a few lines in, and
what?
Yeah. So basically, I just made him a little bit disappointed, maybe a little bit salty, with some caramel on top. You never know. I mean, I kind of went up to him. I was like, "What's up, Matty? Big fan. Fuck you." Kind of like that. I mean, I was like, "Sup, Matty? I'm sorry that I'm your daddy. I'm laughing up in your face, you faggot." Like, I let him know he's a fag.
Yeah.
So like, if you ever want to rap battle somebody, risk getting kicked out, because I only spit a few bars and like, I mean, whatever. I mean, I at least I got my message to him, which was, "Matty, you're a faggot. You're gay. Kill yourself."